In this video, we will demonstrate how to simulate the mixing process of a continuous mixer using EDEM. EDEM is Altair's discrete element method software for simulating bulk and granular material behavior. This is the third part in our video series on mixer design and operation optimization. So if you haven't seen the first two parts, make sure to visit them before watching this video. We're currently in EDEM's creator, which is its preprocessor for setting up the simulation. We've imported the mixer chamber geometry and also created a dummy box, which will be automatically replaced by the STL mesh of the mixer shaft created in Inspire using HyperStudy, as seen in the last video. This mixer shaft has been given a rotational motion so that it will spin around its center axis, mixing the two materials in the system. Next, we'll define the process material we want to simulate. We can define the material and the particle shapes ourselves, or if we have some information about the bulk behavior of our material, we can use EDEM's material wizard, which will suggest appropriate models for our process material, mimicking the behavior based on the characteristics we've defined. Here we can define a number of different behavioral properties, including bulk cohesion, compressibility and bulk density, as well as real-life experimental data from a static angle of repose test or a direct shear test. EDEM will then suggest appropriate models from which we can pick from and import into our simulation. As we can see, a particle with two spheres has been imported into our simulation, and I'm going to copy it to have a mixture of two materials. Since all my material properties have been defined automatically through the wizard, I will only need to add the interaction parameters for my equipment material, which in this case is steel. I can then go into my geometries once again to create factories in order to introduce particles into the system at a fully segregated state. In the factories, I will set the particle generation parameters to create material at a certain rate for an unlimited amount of particles, choosing a different material for each factory, one on the left-hand side of the mixer inlet and one on the right. In the physics section, my EPA parameters have already been defined through the wizard for one material interaction, and I will repeat this for the rest. In order to extract data from the simulation for further analysis, we will proceed to the Analyst tab, which is EDEM's post-processor. In the Analyst, we have set up two different sensors, a geometry bin for tracking particle contacts, as well as a mass flow sensor for tracking the mass flow of each particle at this specific location. Under File, Export, Results Data, we can define different query data to analyze specific information about the simulation results and export them as a CSV file. In this case, we want to look at the mixer shaft's required torque, as well as several particle properties, including mass flow, residence time and number of contacts. We now have our EDEM simulation ready, and we can go back to HyperStudy to automate the creation of mixer geometries and simulation process. In addition to the models we've set up in the previous part of this series for geometry generation, we will add a new EDEM model and point to our continuous mixer deck. This step requires the installation of the EDEM HyperStudy connector, for which the link can be found below. By clicking Import, we will launch the connector, which will allow us to choose from many different EDEM variables for parameterization. In this case, we're going to choose the rotational velocity of the mixer shaft for our operational parameter space. In order to automatically replace the dummy cube with our Inspire-generated mixer, in the EDEM Optionals preference, under our respective profile, specify the Replace Geometry flag calling our text file. This text file will specify the geometry to be replaced, the mesh it will be replaced by, the units, the material, and finally if remeshing needs to be done. In our input variables, we now have the mixer shaft kinematic for rotational velocity. Back in our model resources, we have added the STL as an output file for the operator so that it can be linked to our EDEM operator. We will also include our rgconfig.txt file as an input and copy it over to our third EDEM model. We can now test our model by running the definition. The parameterized file will create a Python file, which will be called by the operator to create the geometry. Next, the geometry will be imported into EDEM for the simulation to begin. By looking into our DEX data folder, we can see that the simulation has started. And that the dummy box has been replaced by our mixer shaft. By looking at the H5 files, we can see that the simulation is progressing. Once the simulation is finished, we can see that the results of our query data has been exported automatically. In HyperStudy, we can select our Define Output Responses tab and go into Data Sources. Here we will tell HyperStudy to read in the query data. We will add a data source. Under Tool, select Read Simulation. We can then point to our results.csv file. And under Component, select our first query. In the time, we will specify the time range of where we want to extract our data from. And in this case, the simulation reaches steady state from 110 seconds onwards. We will then do this for each of the queries. In the Define Output Responses tab, we'll add output responses for each of our queries. We'll take the mean of our data from our custom time period. We can then evaluate responses and get the value for each of our queries. We can then rename our response labels. We can also add other custom output responses and do some feature engineering by defining expressions based on our responses in the expressions column. For example, we have added a segregation index and a total mass flow here. We now have a way of creating inspired geometries, importing them into EDEM, running the simulation, and extracting back the simulation data all automatically. In the next video, we'll show how to optimize our parameter space using machine learning in HyperStudy.